Looking for Magic cards? Channel Fireball offers a wide selection of Magic singles and sealed product. You can now use the promo code LVD at checkout. Hello and welcome to another historic gameplay video. Today we're taking a look at a Paradox Engine combo deck, which features a ton of the new cards from Kaladesh Remastered, and the centerpiece of the deck is Paradox Engine, a 5-mana mythic rare legendary artifact, saying whenever we cast a spell, untap all non-land permanents we control. And Paradox Engine works quite nicely alongside all these mana-generating artifacts, so we can potentially cast a spell, untap all our artifacts, and keep playing more spells out of our hand. And the main combo with Paradox Engine is Mystic Forge, a 4-mana rare artifact, letting us take a look at the top card of our library at any time, and we can cast artifact spells and colorless spells from the top of our library as well, and we can even tap Mystic Forge at the cost of 1 life to exile the top card of our library, so if there's a land on top, we can get rid of it in hopes of finding more spells. And then if we have both Mystic Forge and Paradox Engine in play at the same time, maybe a couple of these mana-generating artifacts, we get to cast spells over the top of our library, untap all those artifacts to generate more mana, and we can potentially even play our entire deck in one big turn. And then the win condition for the deck is one copy of Aetherflux Reservoir, which is an artifact that says whenever we cast a spell, we gain 1 life for each spell we've cast this turn. So even if we play a Reservoir later in the turn, if we've already cast a bunch of spells, it will keep track of that, so we can all of a sudden gain a ton of life as soon as we play Reservoir, and then we can pay 50 life, and then Reservoir deals 50 damage to any target. So eventually we'll gain enough life, so we can pay the 50 and kill our opponent in one activation. And to make sure we've got enough redundancy in the deck, we've got 4 copies of Karn the Great Creator, which can also find all sorts of artifacts in our sideboard, including additional copies of Reservoir, Mystic Forge, Paradox Engine, and even Forsaken Monument, because we are a colorless deck, so Forsaken Monument fits perfectly as a 5-mana legendary artifact. The fact that it pumps our creatures isn't super relevant, but it can come up if Karn turns one of our artifacts into a creature, or if we happen to activate our Guardian Idol or Crawling Barrens, those will get +2/+2, and then whenever we tap a permanent for colorless mana, we can add an additional colorless mana, and whenever we cast a colorless spell, we also gain 2 life, so this also helps us get towards the 50 life necessary to activate Aetherflux Reservoir. Then another new addition from Kaladesh Remastered is Sculpting Steel, a 3-mana mythic rare artifact that enters a battlefield as a copy of any artifact on the battlefield, so it can technically also copy opposing artifacts. But the main combo with Sculpting Steel is Power Stone Shard, a 3-mana artifact that usually taps for 1 colorless mana for each artifact we control named Power Stone Shard. But if we play our Sculpting Steel, it can also decide to copy Power Stone Shard, so we'll have more Power Stone Shards to generate more mana, which all works quite nicely once we start going off with our Paradox Engine and Mystic Forge. So most of the deck just generates mana, and then we've got Mystic Forge as our main card draw engine, Karn to find additional copies of Mystic Forge, and then we can usually combo off in one big turn. So let's take a look at the rest of the deck here. At 2 mana, we've got our full playset of Guardian Idol to generate mana. Can also turn into a 2-2 creature, which works nicely with Forsaken Monument if we need to pressure opposing Planeswalkers, for example. And then we've got 2 copies of Maze Mind Tome, which we can also tap to scry 1 without having to pay any mana. So that can also help us manipulate the top of our deck to get rid of additional lands if we're trying to combo off with Mystic Forge. And we can even untap it with our Paradox Engine to potentially activate it multiple times in the same turn. Then Mindstone as another 2-mana ramp card that can also be sacrificed to draw a card. Sometimes we do end up with a cluster of lands on top of our deck, even after using Mystic Forge, so then being able to draw through those lands to potentially still keep comboing is pretty important, so the effect definitely comes up. Then we've got our 4 copies of Power Stone Shard and 4 copies of Sculpting Steel. Sometimes we do want to copy something different than Power Stone Shard with our Sculpting Steel. For instance, if we already have a ton of mana available, we might be better off copying a Mystic Forge so we can keep manipulating the top of our deck so we don't risk fizzling out. Then 3 copies of Mystic Forge in the main deck with 1 in the sideboard that we can search up with Karn, which is also a pretty well-positioned card in a metagame right now, as people are experimenting with Aetherworks Marvel, which Karn also shuts down thanks to the passive ability, and every now and then we also want to use the +1 ability to turn one of our artifacts into a creature so we can protect our Planeswalker, and also works quite nicely with Forsaken Monument, since it will be a 7-7 if we turn Monument into a creature. then 2 copies of Hedron Archive as an additional ramp card. Now that we have Power Stone Shard and Sculpting Steel to copy Power Stone Shard, we don't need as many copies of Archive as we had in previous versions of the Colorless deck, and then 1 copy of Aetherflux Reservoir can fetch one up in the sideboard as well, and then 3 copies of Monument and 3 copies of Paradox Engine, which are also both legendary, so we don't necessarily want to draw a ton of them, but we've got the 4th copies in the sideboard to search up with Karn. And then going over the mana base, the main difference here from the mana base that we saw in the colorless ramp deck from not too long ago is 1 copy of Inventor's Fair, which also lets us gain 1 life at the beginning of our upkeep if we control 3 or more artifacts, and we can also sacrifice it to search our library for any artifact card and put it into our hand, and we can only activate this if we control 3 or more artifacts. And then we've got kind of the usual suspects with 4 copies of Blast Zone, giving us interaction against some more aggressive decks, Crawling Barrens, an awesome mana sink if we generate a ton of colorless mana, and can also just help us pressure opposing planeswalkers. If the opponent has a Karn the Great Creator, for instance, one of our few answers is to use a Crawling Barrens to attack Karn, so we can keep activating our artifacts. We've got a Ghost Corridor, which can blow up opposing lands. Interplanar Beacon gains a bit of life if we play Karn. We've got our Inventor's Fair, 4 copies of Radiant Fountain, which also gains 2. 1 Scavenger Grounds, which can act as Graveyard Hate, and 4 copies of Zelfern Void, which also lets us scry 1, which is actually pretty important to set up our various combo pieces. And some additional one-offs include Arch of Raska, which can draw cards if we reach the City's Blessing, Buried Ruin to return artifacts from the graveyard to our hand. Cascading Cataracts is here mainly for Golos Tireless Pilgrim in the sideboard, so Golos can fetch up Cascading Cataracts so we can get access to Golos' ability. And then I think we've mentioned all the lands. So going over the sideboard, besides all the combo pieces like Forsaken Monument, Paradox Engine, Mystic Forge and Reservoir, we also have Tormod's Crypt and Gravedigger's Cage as Graveyard Hate. Ratchet Bomb can blow up tokens very quickly. Sorcerer's Spyglass can shut down opposing activated abilities, including Planeswalkers. Then we've got Perilous Vault, which can also act as a sweeper. We've got our Golos, of course, to go with our Cascading Cataracts. We've got a copy of Godfarer's Statue. If we manage to ramp it out quickly, it can also potentially shut down the opponent. Meteor Golem can blow up opposing non-land permanents. Platinum Angel can sometimes win the game against decks that don't have removal for it. And then Metalwork Colossus is also a nice addition from Kaladesh Remastered. Can sometimes play it for 0 mana and get access to a 10/10 artifact creature. And sometimes if it ends up in the graveyard, we can also sacrifice 2 of our artifacts to bring it back. And that can also be useful if we need a 0 mana way to potentially cast a spell to trigger our Paradox Engine to keep comboing. So sometimes it can be important for that as well. And then Stonecoil Serpent, another creature that we can search up and potentially sink a ton of our extra mana into. So yeah, that's our deck. Now let's jump into some games and see how the deck does. Alright, we're on the play with a nice looking hand. Lots of cheap ramp and have a Karn to get Mystic Forge, Paradox Engine in hand already. So I'll wait on Zelfern Void, give myself an extra draw step to the side. Now that I drew a land, I probably don't need more lands, so we'll play Void. And Reservoir, I typically don't want to draw early on, so we'll put that on the bottom. Opponent gets a Swamp. And a Temple of Malice tapped. So off to a pretty slow start. Cauldron Familiar, Sir Point on the Sacrifice deck. Well, Karn can shut down a potential Witch's Oven and can also get Graveyard Hate if needed. For now, yeah, I guess playing Karn's okay, and then we can get Mystic Forge. If we get to minus 2 Karn again, could also get Forsaken Monument to generate more mana. There's Priest, don't care too much about Priest. Although I could technically get Sorcerer's Spyglass to prevent the activated ability. Alright, we drew another Mystic Forge. How do we feel about getting Forsaken Monument instead of some Graveyard Hate here? Yeah, it seems okay.
You will not threaten this world.
Mayhem Devil can represent quite a bit of damage. But we've got life gain thanks to Monuments, and a backup Karn's always nice. So where do we begin? So I essentially have 12 mana here. If I play Paradox Engine first and then Mystic Forge, I get some untapped triggers as well. So I could play Power Stone Shard, get to untap my Guardian Idol. And then we get to tap these two. Play Mystic Forge. See what's on top. Yeah, there's a chance we can just win this turn. Alright, there's a Sculpting Steel on top, so double Q to float all our mana, go full control to potentially use Mystic Forge in response here, and I will be doing that so we get rid of the Arch of Araska. Resolve. And then we'll copy Power Stone Shard. Float all our mana once again, full control. Cast Archive. No need to use Mystic Forge. Double Q, full control, cast Mind Stone, and I will be using Mystic Forge before it untaps. Double Q, full control, play Mystic Forge, no need to use Mystic Forge. Double Q, Mind Stone, no need to use Mystic Forge. And we're getting pretty close to the point where we just want to Karn minus for Aetherflux Reservoir. Yeah, I think that's probably okay. So, float some mana first. Get a Reservoir. Float some mana, full control. Cast Maze Mind Tome. Alright, so we actually needed both activations here, so untap everything. We can always decide to draw with Mind Stone or Hedron Archive as well if we get in the spot. Alright, so we exceeded 50 life, but I do have to be careful because I do have a priest in play. So we'll go a little bit above 50 here, just to play it safe. Alright, that should suffice. And yeah, it's time to fire the laser. So we managed to combo off in the very same turn where we cast Paradox Engine, thanks to Forsaken Monument also generating a ton of mana. Sweet, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the draw. This hand can generate a ton of mana. We're missing a card draw engine like Mystic Forge or Karn to search up Mystic Forge, but I think it's keepable. I also have the Crawling Barons and Guardian Idol, which can turn into creatures, which also benefit from monuments. So that's kind of our plan B. Opponent on Temple of Mystery. Ooh, there's Karn. So yeah, if Karn gets Mystic Forge, we kind of have all the pieces we need. Eventually finds a Paradox Engine as well. Opponent on Teemer and a Lightning Stormkin. So maybe an aggressive elemental deck. So next turn I could go Sculpting Steel, copy Guardian Idol, play Mind Stone. Or I guess Mind Stone and then play Sculpting Steel, copying Mind Stone, since Mind Stone's probably more valuable than Guardian Idol once we start comboing. Arisen Reef. Finds Breeding Pool. Does Mind Stone change anything? Think we stick to the plan. And then having a cheaper spell in hand could be more useful later, as opposed to playing the Mind Stone now. Scampering Scorcher with Risen Reef in play is a pretty nice sequence. Gets to draw three cards. So we don't have a lot of time here to set up our combo. Inventor's Fair could definitely come in handy at finding the last combo piece. So here I can go Monuments into Mindstone, can play it for free, which is probably okay. I could also hold it to potentially untap with Paradox Engine, but in this case I'll just gain a life to play it safe. And then Karn probably gets Mystic Forge. It is possible that getting like a Platinum Angel could win the game if they don't have removal for it, but we'll just get the Mystic Forge, which is more fun. And then Inventor's Fair could maybe grab Paradox Engine, and then we're off to the races. Trailblazer pumps all elementals by one, so it's gonna be close. Currently scheduled to take 11 damage, so I'm dead to a second Trailblazer. Thunderkin Awakener. Okay. I'm at 3. Back up to 4. Alright, so we just gotta win this turn. Shouldn't be too difficult. So let me make sure I don't mess up my sequencing. So step 1. Probably get Paradox Engine with Karn.
I will not lose another friend.
Then I want to float the mana from my artifacts. Usually you want to just double tap Q to float all your mana, but in this case I might want to crack my Inventor's Fair. So I'll wait, play Paradox Engine, play Mystic Forge to untap everything. And then I should probably just use my Inventor's Fair now to grab my Aetherflux Reservoir to make it a bit faster. And we also get a free shuffle. And then I can start double tapping Q. And in response here, I technically should have tapped my Mystic Forge to get rid of the land, but I forgot. I'll do it now. But we should be in decent shape here. Still have Maze Mind Tome to untap everything and Scry to make sure we don't fizzle. And in the meantime, we start gaining a life. So I'll use Mystic Forge. Get rid of my lands. And it shouldn't take too long here to win with all three combo pieces in play. Double tap Q, cast a Karn. Again, I should have been in full control here to exile my lands. But it shouldn't matter too much. Double tap Q, can activate Forge. Alright, I'll go full control this time, but it's not necessary since we have a Sculpting Steel on top. Double tap Q, Sculpting Steel, can copy a Reservoir maybe. I've got too many artifacts in play, can't see them anymore. And we'll use Mystic Forge, play Archive, and we've exceeded 50 life, so it's time to fire off the Reservoir. Bam! Alright, sweet, so yeah, you can see how quickly the deck can start comboing as soon as it finds a copy of Mystic Forge and a copy of Paradox Engine. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a nice opening hand. Good to turn to Guardian Idol, some additional ramp with Shard, and then Mystic Forge as a nice draw engine. So what are we missing here? Paradox Engine, pretty much. I'll wait one turn to play Void just to see what we draw. If I draw lands, I don't need to keep one on top. If we don't draw land, I might want to keep land 4. So play Void. Sculpting Steel is nice with Barstone Shard. But are we better off with a land at this point? I think so. Opponent with a turn 1 Temple of Mystery into Temple Garden. So banned deck. And Transcendent Envoy, so it's an enchantment aura deck. Alright, what are we doing here? Can just play Mystic Forge, can go Power Stone Shard plus Guardian Idol, and then next turn play Mystic Forge and have access to more mana. That seems a little better. When in doubt, developing your mana first is usually better. So, gonna see a Satyr Enchanter. Another reason to play green is for the 3 mana aura that bumps for each enchantment in play. So that could represent a ton of damage. For now we can play Mystic Forge. Typically don't want to tap Power Stone Shard if possible, because we can potentially draw another one and then it can tap for 2 mana. Although in this case it's probably not gonna matter too much. And yeah, I guess we'll activate Mystic Forge. And then I can still play Tome. And then I could Scry, but there's no 1 mana card I can find and still cast, so I'll just pass. And then we're just looking for Paradox Engine or Karn the Great Creator. Daxus triggers Enchanter. And a Nyx Fleece Ram, that's fine. Bottom the Beacon. And then on upkeep, don't want to draw Crawling Baron, so we'll get rid of it with Mystic Forge. And there's Karn, so we'll draw that for the turn. So I could play Karn minus get Paradox Engine. I think I would rather just scry with a Maze Mind Tome here. See if we find something else we can cast over the top. Sculpting Steel, perfect. So now I can play the Sculpting Steel copying Power Stone Shard. Forsaken Monument's also great. So I can play Monuments. I think I'll tap both Shards and my Crawling Barons. And then I can still play Archive or Karn. Archive only taps for 3 mana with Monument in place, so not enough to play Karn afterwards. But yeah, that seems fine. Just develop my mana, gain a bit of life back. And then next turn we should be in perfect position to combo off. Even an Inventor's Fair to maybe find a combo piece. So let's see if they have an Ancestral Mask. It's going to be a Destiny Spinner. Don't really see them killing me from 18. Citizen Training. Maybe with like double All That Glitters. Yeah, they would get close if they had that, but they don't. And another Nyx Fleece Ram. Alright. So I think we're good to go here. Luckily our opponent didn't apply a ton of pressure. So step one is probably Karn gets Paradox Engine. And then double tap Q to float all our mana. Play Engine. Cast a Guardian Idol. And I forgot to go full control before casting it to potentially still use Mystic Forge. That's gonna be something that I'm gonna miss pretty often. I'll use Mystic Forge now. Mind Stone. Go full control. Play Mind Stone. No need to use the Mystic Forge here. And then tap everything again, go full control, cast Power Stone Shard. No need to use Mystic Forge. Double tap Q, go full control. Cast Sculpting Steel, no need to use Mystic Forge. And then we'll copy the Power Stone Shard here. I guess it's time to just Inventor's Fair for my copy of Aetherflux Reservoir here to make it a bit faster. So we've got a Reservoir in hand. Can still use Mystic Forge first. Also have a Maze Mind Tome to scry, so I can just cast my Paradox Engine to untap everything. And we'll keep one of them. This would be easier if my artifacts weren't hidden behind 50 menus, but that's okay. Cast Monuments. And keep one of them. Alright, I guess we'll cast a Reservoir now. Make a bunch of mana. Not playing optimally, as you can tell. No need to get rid of Paradox Engine since it's an extra untap trigger. Alright, we're at 52, so time to shoot. And there we go. Sweet. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the draw with a keepable hand, plenty of 2 mana ramp, plus Karn to maybe get a Mystic Forge. Opponent with Allures of the Dream Den. And an island, so could be maybe a blue-white aura deck. Ooh, Merfolk Windrobber, so could be blue-black rogues instead. Sadly, don't have Blast Zone, which could come in handy. Turn to Thought Thief. Mills a copy of Blast Zone. And a Karn. Alright, let's get a Guardian Idol in play. I might decide to next turn go Guardian Idol plus Mindstone instead of Karn, so I can maybe Karn minus and cast whatever we draw right away. So these rogues are going to start hitting pretty hard as soon as we get 8 cards in graveyard, which we do now. Radiant Fountain to gain a bit of life back. So I'm taking 9 down to 12. Yeah, if they have any counter spells left in hand, we're in a lot of trouble. And our opponent is keeping up 3 mana. Well, time to play Karn. Get to gain 1 life at the very least. And Drown in a Loch gonna counter it. And I guess we'll Sculpting Steel, copying Mind Stone here. So, it seems unlikely for us to have a chance this game. I would need to draw Mystic Forge and then probably draw Perfect from there. And our opponent passes again with 3 mana up. Yeah, this is probably game over. All my Karns are also in my graveyard. And my Reservoir, so those are most of my win conditions. Of course, we could technically still win with Crawling Barrens if we generate enough mana. So, what am I doing here? draw with the Mind Stone, see what happens. Forsaken Monument. It's just gonna get countered and also doesn't gain me enough life to survive anyway. So, draw again with Mind Stone. But yeah, we should be out of outs. Blast Zone can blow up a Wind Robber, but still taking 6. Let's see if they had a counterspell left over here. Alright, they did. So we never really had a chance this game. Yeah, early pressure backed up by counterspells is a pretty good combination to beat this deck. Alright, good game. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play, and this hand is missing some ramp. Sculpting Steel doesn't have anything to copy at the moment, so this hand's actually not that great, and I'm willing to mulligan. This is a bit better. So, I probably keep 3 lands, Guardian Idol, Maze Mind Tome, and then pretty much hope that we draw additional lands to eventually cast our Forsaken Monument. Tome seems important as a way to find more combo pieces. Inventor's Fair could be nice too. So next turn we can play Tome and draw a card, at the very least. The best part about Inventor's Fair is the fireworks sound effect. Alright, opponent on a 5-color Sanctum deck. So, let's play Tome and draw a card. And I can potentially scry on upkeep. Revitalize, okay. Blast Zone could potentially blow up the opponent's Sanctum, but don't think that'll be necessary. We'll just draw a card, and then play out our Forsaken Monuments. And then I'm looking for Mystic Forge, that's probably the main one. We've got a ton of mana now thanks to Monument, so Mystic Forge is even more important than Paradox Engine. And of course Karn can also find all those cards, so that's a fine draw as well. Alright, Sculpting Steel could copy any of our artifacts, including Maze Mind Tome. Let's start by playing Mind Stone, since I can essentially play it for free. And then I'll draw a card here. And then, yeah, I might want to just copy my Maze Mind Tome. And draw some more cards. Alright, I think we're done for the turn. This can generate 3 mana so we can pump up our Crawling Barrens. And then next turn we can go digging with our 2 copies of Maze Mind Tome. No shortage of mana. Honden of Life's Web. That's fine, so we can also now use Inventor's Fair to potentially find Mystic Forge. Let's cry here. Don't need more idols. Yeah, I'll just cry with Tome, I think. Draw. And then, yeah, I suppose I should just activate Inventor's Fair at this point. Could draw first, so we don't kinda waste all the cards we put on the bottom earlier. But I think if we find a Mystic Forge, we should be able to combo off. Maybe I shouldn't have scryed with the Maze Mind Tomes, since once we find a Mystic Forge, we can use the scry effects to keep drawing through the deck. Play play Forge. So there's a land on top, which I can get rid of with the Forge. And there's Paradox Engine, so that should pretty much seal the deal. Cast Mystic Forge, untap all our artifacts. Can double tap Q to float all our mana, which can be useful. So as long as there are spells on top of my deck, I don't need to use Mystic Forge, but one thing we need to do is go full control, so we can potentially use Mystic Forge before we untap all our permanents. If we don't go full control, we're not able to do that. So we got rid of the lands before we actually untapped all our permanents with Paradox Engine. And yeah, once we get to the stage, we are pretty much guaranteed to draw our entire deck, eventually find Aether Flux Reservoir or Karn the Great Creator to find Reservoir, and then we can kill our opponent. Alright, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the play, facing a Lurrus of the Dream Den deck. Yeah, this hand's probably keepable. And then start out with a Radiant Fountain. Turn to Maze Mind Tome to scry towards our missing combo pieces. Our opponent's on the red-black Pyromancer build, so the card advantage from Maze Mind Tome is also quite useful. Double Karn the Great Creator, so those can search up maybe some Graveyard Hate as well if needed. Opponent with Fatal Push, another new addition from Kaladesh Remastered, and a Thoughtseize. Gonna try and punch a hole in our game plan here. Takes Power Stone Shard. So I wouldn't mind scrying towards a bit of ramp. Could also just draw with the Maze Mind Tome, so maybe we'll do that instead. And then no need to do it now, since we don't have any 1 mana artifacts. Crocs are gonna make me discard. I guess now I'll draw with a tomb. Do I want to get rid of Karn? Not necessarily. Could just keep double Karn. The first Karn can minus get Tormod Script to exile the opponent's graveyard, perhaps. Yeah, I think I just get rid of a land. And claim to bring back Kroxa. Alright, now do I get rid of Karn? Probably. Opponent's got 6 cards in graveyard, so I need to Karn and then Tormod Script right away. But that seems fine. So Kroxa is gone, and we should still be able to activate Karn a second time. Alright, never mind, Bedevil kills Karn.
I will be better prepared.
So now I probably have to just draw with the Tome to get a bit of card advantage going. I also still have Inventor's Fair, so if we find a third artifact we can maybe search up a Mystic Forge. So don't think I'll be scrying with my tomb. Ooh, another Karn. Alright, so I could Karn minus get Mystic Forge. That's kind of my first instinct, or I could Hedron Archive and draw with tomb. And then next turn I'll have 7 mana at the very least. Still not enough to Karn and play Mystic Forge unless I draw land, but I guess I'm pretty likely to draw another land here. So this is a little riskier if they top deck another Thoughtseize. I guess I should wait with drawing with the Tome here, just in case they have double Thoughtseize. So I'll take one. Opponent puts Lures in hand and doesn't have anything else. Alright, so their hand could just be a bunch of creature removal. Picked up a Guardian Idol. So I do like scrying to hit my land drop so I can play Karn and play Mystic Forge. Mind Stone I'll have to bottom. Another Karn, alright. I guess that works too. So I get to go Karn. Minus for Mystic Forge. Don't think there's anything in their graveyard I care about. And Mystic Forge will pull us furthest ahead. Could also get a Metal War Colossus at some point, which we can cast for pretty cheap. And can't forget about Inventor's Fair. Village Rites to sacrifice that your supplier draw two. They did also mill Dreadhorde Arcanists, which they can maybe replay. We're just gonna replay the Stitcher Supplier. Plays Arcanists, that's fine. Alright, so we get to untap with a ton of mana available, and even drew a Monument. So where should we begin? I also don't hate getting a copy of Gravedigger's Cage. So we can shut off access to the graveyard even more. So if we start with playing Monuments. Offensive. Minus for Cage. Play Mystic Forge. And then next turn I can get a Paradox Engine. So can't cast this if I also want to play Cage, which seems more important. And then I'll decide end of turn whether I want to get rid of Guardian Idol or not. Now one thing to keep in mind about Gravedigger's Cage is that it also prevents us from casting spells from our library, so it does stop Mystic Forge from casting spells over the top, but we can usually still work around it and find another way to win the game, even if it doesn't involve the Paradox combo. And my opponent explodes, sweet, so we managed to lock our opponents out of doing anything relevant thanks to Karn searching up some graveyard hate. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with an acceptable hand. Plenty of ramp, we're currently missing a bit of card draw to go with it. But we can always sacrifice Mindstone. Turn one Vampire of Dire Moon, so maybe a black vampire deck. And you know, all good things start with a turn 2 Mindstone. So black-white vampires with a Legion Lieutenant. Whoa, I got some special effects going there. So do I want to Sculpting Steel? Could go Mindstone into Sculpting Steel, that seems fine. Got the fireworks from the Inventor's Fair in the background. And a Gifted Aetherborn, that's fine. So we already have the three artifacts required to potentially sacrifice Inventor's Fair if we need to get a Mystic Forge, for instance. So this turn, play Monuments. And then I'll save the Sculpting Steel to maybe copy a Power Stone Shard later, or maybe Mystic Forge to keep comboing. And then we'll just pass for now. Sanctum Seeker, alright, that does represent quite a bit of damage. Guardian Idol. So I think it's time to get my Mystic Forge going here. Could also Karn for Mystic Forge, but I think I would rather save the mana. And then I don't want to tap my Mind Stones. Would rather tap Guardian Idol, although Guardian Idol could also turn into a creature potentially, so that's useful. So I guess I can tap one Mind Stone. Karn on top. Guess I'll take it. And then I can cast Guardian Idol for free, gain a bit of life. Karn could get Paradox Engine for next turn so we can combo. Am I gonna survive a hit for 15? Here's a question. I guess I'll gain two more after casting a spell. So I'll be at 17. So we're gonna be cutting it close. If they have another Lieutenant or Sanctum Seeker, I could be dead. So the question here is whether I want to maybe get a zero mana card I can play with Karn to gain two more life.
My grief fuels my mission.
Yeah, that might be worth it. Alright, I meant to get a Metalwork Colossus or at least Stonequill Serpent there, but I was kind of panicking. I thought I was timing out, so I grabbed Tormod Script, which was the first zero mana card I could see. So hopefully it doesn't come back to bite us if they have Legion Lieutenant or Sanctum Seeker here, but otherwise we should still be able to survive and combo off. Alright, we get to untap. I'm probably fine drawing Hedron Archive. And then get Paradox Engine, and that should pretty much seal the deal.
Stand down.
So double tap Q. Guess we'll use Mystic Forge as well here. Untap everything as soon as we play another artifact. And we can keep going. Use Mystic Forge. Can Sculpting Steel to copy Mystic Forge, or we can just play another one. Yeah, I think we're in the clear now. And my opponent concedes. Sweet. So yeah, our deck just needs to get one good turn with Paradox Engine, and then it's usually game over. So this isn't going to be the most competitive Historic deck out there, especially in Best of One, since some of the faster decks in Historic usually win around turn 4, and we're a deck that doesn't interact all that much and on average will win around turn 5 if all goes according to plan, so it's definitely not the fastest combo deck in existence. But the upside here is that we don't play any creatures, so decks that try to interact with us through creature removal are going to have a hard time disrupting our combo. So against anything playing black or red removal spells, we've got a leg up over other combo decks that rely on creatures. And yeah, as you've seen, it doesn't take much for the deck to combo off, so the deck's a lot more consistent than might appear at first glance, and we get to take advantage of all those colorless utility lands in combination with Forsaken Monument, so that's a powerful combination too. So if you're sick of using Ugin as a win condition in your colorless ramp decks, you can maybe give Paradox Engine a try. So that's gonna do it for today's gameplay. Wanna thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day! I also want to thank all my patrons for being part of the channel, and you can become a patron yourself today and decide the topic of future videos over at patreon.com/legendvd.